physically the last 48 hours after the game?
Pretty good. You know, I've practiced, but there's nothing like a game to be able to, you know, kind of try to anticipate how I'm going to feel. That was kind of big for me, is to see, you know, how I would feel after the game. A little sore, but, you know, I feel good.
Cameron caught that shot of you kind of on a knee after the game-winning drive. Mm-hmm. Can you kind of articulate what you were thinking in that moment?
Yeah, I told JG, was like, show me some love. You know, I was walking off the field, and I was like, bro, we got to win. We ain't won the game yet, you know. So, obviously got full faith in, you know, Prater to knock it down. But it was just, you know, obviously a good moment, you know, a great moment for us to go down 2-minute drill, first game back, be able to win the game. That was the most important thing, was, you know, win the game. So I was happy about that.
It was just a start. What do you expect out of yourself moving forward the final stretch?
Just trying to get better each week. I thought it started off solid. You know, some misses here and there that, you know, obviously we'd love to have back. But, you know, for the first game back, I thought I was felt comfortable out there. Didn't feel, you know, sped up or anything like that. So it was good to, you know, be back in the mix.
Are you in a place where it's kind of like, okay, with that first one out of the way, everything's normal again? Or do you feel like you're still kind of working into normal?
I mean, I don't know. You know, normal is, it's, I was talking to somebody the other day, one of my boys, you know, it's when you're used to winning and you've played at, you know, that high of a level and you know what that feels like. Like, it's kind of a baseball reference as well. Like, when you're playing at that level, it's a, you're always on edge. You know, you're never really comfortable. And I think great players kind of understand, like, when I say you're always on edge, it's you're trying to stay in that, you know, whatever zone that you're in, you're trying to stay in it. However you get in it, as long as possible, you know, especially in baseball, it's such a mental sport. You know, I say that because even if I hit 2 home runs, you know, I still go home and be like, okay, how do I continue this? I don't relax and feel like, okay, I had a good game today. No, I got to keep doing it. And that's the same thing for me as far as football goes. It's like, okay, I felt good, but I need to keep playing well, or I need to, how do I get better the next week? You know, so I'm always, you know, never at ease with what went on the past week, trying to get better and move forward.
Kind of piggybacking off of that, you know, your whole life you've been, you know, one of the best. You know, when you step onto the field, you always know that, you know, your talent can kind of will you to win. But when you go through what you went through, where that challenge kind of just taken away and you have to fight so hard to get back to do it, and then you get that first game back, how does that feel for you personally to know that you kind of
I mean, I never waver, you know. As far as getting hurt goes, like, that's nothing I can control. You know, that was something I can't control. I think everything happens for a reason. If anything, it just allowed me to sit back and, you know, kind of just, you know, be in my own, you know, kind of zone and just see the game from afar, something that's never been taken away from me. I've always played, you know, never really been hurt. And even when I was hurt, I'd play. So to be able to sit back, I guess it was kind of good for me. But as far as the talent, I don't think the talent just leaves. I think mentally, that's, you know, people get messed up is, you know, if you're not, you know, mentally strong or you know, see it differently than that. But
given that you've been in all the meetings all along, even though you couldn't be on the field, is there any part of you that feels like this is still a little bit of a training camp process for you in terms of absorbing this offense, or because you've been in all those meetings, that's not, you're well past that?
I'm pretty comfortable with it. I will say, you know, being a different offense for the past 4 years, it was new. It was definitely new. A lot of, you know, terminology and stuff like that, being out there, seeing a certain coverage and, you know, thinking back to, like, old, you know, old habits or things that we would do. But at the same time, being in the moment and not, you know, not being able to go to what I would normally go to, having to stay with what we're doing now. There's definitely some old habits that want to, you know, creep back in when you're out there. But no, it's good. You know, breaking those habits, trusting the process, and you know, what Drew's coaching, teaching, it's been great. But no, as far as the training, no, I don't feel like those reps. Like last year, I missed a lot of reps. I felt a little different. This year, I feel pretty good.
With the new scheme, you told us before that game that you liked it, you felt comfortable. but it's different than practice. So now that you have that game experience, a little bit better feel for it, how is it going to allow you to do what you do best?
Say that again.
The Moose game.
Yeah.
How is it going to allow you to do what you do best?
I just think, you know, it's I can go into the game just trusting it, you know, and just allowing myself to be me. If it's like, you know, the superhero plays and stuff like that, like, they just happen. You know, it's not forced. It's just play within the system. You know, obviously do what we're coached, do what we're taught. And then if something breaks down, do what you need to do and, you know, make something happen. But other than that, you know, I think we're being coached well. I love the scheme. I love what we're doing. You know, and the attention to detail to it all is really what I love the most. So,
are you a different person, teammate, player after going through all of this?
I think I'm a different person. I think so. I think just some things that, you know, happen to you, you can't really control. It just, you know, either elevates you or bring you down. But I think this is one of those things that, like I said, everything happens for a reason. I think it was for the better, not only for me, but just for everyone, you know. And I think that, you know, a lot of people keep saying that I'm a different, you know, he's such a better leader now, he's this and that. Like, I just think people, I don't want to get too much into it, but it's just, you know, the light's different right now. You know, I think people around me, teammates, everybody, it's just different energy.
The video is out there with you talking about Bruce Lee, and you all know the respect and admiration. How much did that help you through this long process?
That's just the mentality. You know, that's always stuck with me. You know, I know that's something that, you know, that's inside of you. You know, it's not something that you just pick up one day, or, you know, you try to live by one day. No, that's as soon as I got hurt, you know, like I said, I had one day, really not really one day, but just the moment after it happened, and then on the way to the car. But after that, it was just kind of like, all right, you know, we gotta go, we gotta get better. It's in God's hands. I trust and believe in everything that's about to happen. And how do we work hard and get back to it, you know? So that was the mentality.
Kyler, was there anything you learned about yourself physically on Sunday that, you know, hey, I did this, or I can do more of this now, or just anything like that you were curious how your body would respond?
Yeah, sliding, taking a hit, you know, scrambling for the first time. All those things, you know, I've done it in practice. I haven't slid in practice or got hit, but I've, you know, running around and stuff like that to do it, you know, first time I took off that third down, I felt kind of slow. But it was, you know, it was kind of an eye opener, like, okay, we're good. And then, you know, like I said, it was just, you know, feeling the aches and sorenesses after the game and stuff like that. But other than that, it was try to, you know, prepare myself hard, you know, for that moment. So.
There are a lot of new faces on that offensive line that you haven't had the chance to play behind. What was it like playing behind them? And also, when Paris was drafted, you were very excited to have that franchise right tackle over there. How has your relationship kind of evolved with him?
I was good. Obviously, DJ was down. Beach had to step in. Tristan's got hurt. So, we, you know, O'Connell's at left guard. It was a bunch of new faces. But it was good, you know, obviously just trying to do my job, get the ball out if need be, to help those guys out. You know, pretty good team over there. But, you know, as far as drafting Paris, obviously anytime I feel like a quarterback gets, you know, a guy that is as talented and as good as him, you're going to be happy, you know, because if you can stand up in the pocket, stand up straight, keep you upright, feel like you'd be pretty good, so.
Sort of warning of, like, hey, I can make some plays.
JG told him in the meeting, he had a holding call. He was I just think, you know, it's a little different playing with me, obviously, but he'll figure it out. You know, he's played at a high level his whole life, so it's not too much, you know, too much different. I think he'll be good.
Kyler, you won Rookie of the Year, you know, your first year.
And yeah.
I'm sure you can appreciate what CJ Stroud is doing right now. What are your thoughts on how he's taking the league by storm?
I love it. I love it. You know, to see what he's doing, man, it's I love it. You know, it's for a fellow African-American quarterback to be doing what he's doing at this level, you know, especially in his rookie year, it's impressive. But it's just, you know, if you love the game, if you really love the art and, you know, the detail of the position, he's playing it the right way. He's obviously leading those guys. They believe in him. They trust in him. So I'm proud of him. I mean, you know what I'm saying? I'm excited to see his career.
You
obviously faced D'Amico Ryan's defense several times in your career. What are your impressions of this version of D'Amico Ryan's defense?
Similar, you know, obviously similar, you know, played 49ers in the past, even this year. I think it's a similar defense, so I'm excited to, you know, line it up and go against them.
You called in the video, you posted the win, mm-hmm. a perfect ending, I guess, to that day.
Yeah.
In that process, like, did you get to kind of think about that a little bit more after the game?
A perfect night is winning the game. You know, that's obviously, you know, you could do more, throw more touchdowns, run for more yards, whatever it may be, but at the end of the day, all I wanted to do was win the game. So that was, you know, that's what made it a perfect night.
How are you with the package that apparently was used Sunday and might be used going forward with Clayton with those certain situations?
Yeah, no, because they took the touchdown off the board and then they told Clayton to go in, which I obviously, I knew situation. But I was like, it was on the half yard inch. I was just joking on the sideline. I was like, I'm about to go back in the game. And it was good. I was, you know, just happy we scored.
Throw down the sideline, the tray earlier in the game, kind of laid out the PI was calling, still pulled it in. Does that just kind of reinforce trust in Trey throughout, you know, further down the road in that game?
Yeah, I mean, you know, he got going early, not really predetermining reads or anything like that. You know, just for me, just, you know, going to where the ball's supposed to go and playing clean that way. Obviously, when you play like that, usually good things happen. And he made a play. I mean, obviously, I think he was feeling good that, you know, Sunday. So I don't know how many yards he had, but it was a good day for him.
Did you sense any kind of rust from yourself?
Well, I kept asking, I was like, how's it look, you know, because I, you know, it didn't feel rusty, you know, I didn't feel as far as getting out there. Obviously, we go 3-and-out, but I didn't know what to really expect. I felt, you know, felt good throughout this whole process, get out there and just kind of see where it goes, but I felt good, you know, I felt good, I felt confident, and I think, I don't know. You know. You be the judge. I let y'all be the judge. But I feel solid.
Will you, in this whole process, did you take time to reflect on, you know, what you're talking about, the moment being caught off the field?
Mm-hmm.
And was there any doubt that crept in? Did you go back to that at all, or did you move forward from here?
No. You know, I know certain people don't like to watch themselves getting hurt or, you know, things like that. To me, it all feels like a blur. It feels like it really kind of never happened. It's hard to explain, but. Now that I'm in this moment, like it just feels like this is where I'm supposed to be. All that, I know I've been hurt, but, you know, all the work, doing the same thing every day. Like I said, it feels like it went by so quick. And now that we're here. So it's kind of weird, but no doubts.
Have you watched it?
I mean, obviously, I've seen it. Yeah, I've seen it.
How big was it at the end of the game with everything going on? And then the James play where he went down,
yeah.
And that whole process of making sure everyone was on the same page.
Just something that we practice. I think every team should practice. I'm sure they do. You know, in the game situations, in the half situations, pride ourselves on being coached, a good coach team. And obviously, you know, JG, Drew, they make sure we rehearse those situations, and we execute it well.
JG said you look maybe even better than he expected. Does he express that kind of stuff to you, or does he try to keep you?
I told y'all, you know, he was trying to put a, you know, not a gauge on, you know, calm down, let it, you know, he might not look like how, you know, it's looked before, but hell, I don't even know if he knew what was going to look like. I didn't, so, you know, I expect to go out there and make plays and do my thing. And I think there's a lot of room to grow and improve. You know, I think it was a good start, but, you know, I think we can all get better.
As emotional potentially as that game could have been, he said he was impressed how even keeled you were,
mm-hmm.
with everything going on in that game. Was that something you were sort of conscious of, or is that just kind of how you always are?
I think I'm always that way. Obviously, when things go bad, you got to, you know, control the body language and stuff like that. Every player goes through it. But no, I've never been a guy that's up and down. I don't like the ebbs and flows. You know, people are too up and down for me. It's kind of, we don't really vibe well. You know, I'm kind of like, if you know me, I'm really steady. So that's how I try to be. You know, everybody's looking at me when bad stuff happens. Obviously, there's moments where we all get frustrated and stuff like that, but for the most part, try to stay even keel and give these guys confidence because they're always looking to me. So that's how it's always been, really.
How was the communication during the game with Drew and on the field and in this first time out?
It was great. It was great. You know, obviously a different voice that I'm used to, but, you know, he was great. The communication was solid, awesome. You know, he's really, like I said, the attention to detail with him is major. And for me, I love it because, you know, he's always got a reason for why what we're doing. You know, he always has an answer for any question that we have. So it's great.
Are you following what Josh is doing up in Minnesota at all?
Who?
Josh Dobbs.
Oh yeah, I've seen it. I watch football. Yeah. No, it's great. I mean, it's great. You know, it's I'm happy for him. You know, for him to be, you know, him being in the league this long and finally, you know, kind of get his opportunity to, you know, show or prove to people, you know, his ability and how he can put a stamp on a game is good for him.
What's your reaction to just what he's done twice now this season with all the talk with you and all learning the new, and then he comes and does this twice? Is that, it's got to be pretty surprising.
What are we talking about? Are we talking about the Vikings? Are we talking about the Vikings? Like,
well, he's coming here too.
Yeah.
So it happened twice.
What happened twice?
I'm just curious what your thoughts on that is.
I'm happy for him. I'm happy for him. We're 2-8. We got to keep going, though.